Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the topic breeding and biotechnology. What is breeding? Breeding means production or reproduction of living things. Okay. By nature, plants and animals reproduce on their own. What is plant breeding? Plant breeding means developing new plant varieties. Plant breeding is a process by which humans change certain aspects of plants over time in order to introduce desired characteristics. It means what? Developing a new variety of plant. Whatever characteristics we require, we will modify the plant by breeding it. Okay. For example, you can see a lot of hibiscus flower here, it means shoe flower here. There are various varieties here with colors and texture and also size and shape, and the layers of the petals also, there are many varieties. Animal breeding. What is animal breeding? Animal breeding is the process of selective mating of animals with the desirable genetic traits. Okay. So some selective characteristics you can pick up and you can breed that characteristics alone, and you can mate with an animal with the another one. Okay. Here you can see a lot of varieties of dogs. So here you can see only the varieties. Okay. Varieties of dogs. So, what is the necessity of this breeding? Breeding of a plant or animal. What is the necessity? India's population will be 1.7 billion by 2050. 1.7 billion. Just think of that. So, at that time, India's food production will be only 59%. So, remaining percent of food will be a demand. Okay, so there will be a food demand. So this can be made possible by plant breeding and animal husbandry. Okay, food production is to improve the quality of human life. Okay, for that reason we have to breed the plant and animals. Modern agricultural practices and crop improvement. It includes the preparation of soil, sowing, application of manures and fertilizers, proper irrigation, protection from weeds and pests, harvesting, threshing, and storage. So, to improve the cultivation of plants, we need a modern agricultural practice. The aim of the crop improvement is to develop improved crop varieties with higher yield, better quality, resistance to diseases, and with shorter duration. Okay, you can see here a maize with lesser quantity and underdeveloped grains. Here you can see a well-developed grains, but the quantity is very small. And this is well-developed grains, but the arrangement is not proper here. So these two are intermediates. Okay. And this is the modern corn. So this is our aim, to produce the higher yield, better quality, resistance to disease, and within shorter duration we have to produce the food. Okay. Green revolution. What is green revolution? In Tamil we will call that as Pasumai Purachi. So why this happened? Yen Purachi seidanga, Pasumai Purachi niya seidanga appadina, there was a vast பாப்புலேஷன் பாப்புலேஷன் இன்க்ரீஸ் ரொம்ப இருந்துச்சு. ஸோ அந்த டைமில் ஃபுட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் ரொம்ப கம்மியாக இருந்ததுனால வி ஹாவ் டு ப்ரொவைட் ஃபுட் ஃபார் ஆல் தி பீப்புள். ஓகே, அட் தட் டைம் வி ஹாவ் டு ப்ரொடியூஸ் அ லார்ஜ் குவான்டிட்டி ஆஃப் ஃபுட். ஃபார் தேட் ஒன்லி திஸ் வாஸ் கண்டக்டட், திஸ் பசுமை புரட்சி கிரீன் ரெவல்யூஷன் கண்டக்டட். ஸோ இட் இஸ் தி ப்ராசஸ் ஆஃப் இன்க்ரீஸிங் ஃபுட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் த்ரூ ஹை ஈல்டிங் க்ராப் வெரைட்டிஸ் அண்ட் மாடர்ன் அக்ரிகல்ச்சரல் டெக்னிக்ஸ் இன் அண்டர் டெவலப்டு அண்ட் டெவலப்பிங் நேஷன்ஸ். சி, ஹீஸ் நம்மாழ்வார். தமிழில் நம்ம கூப்பிடுவோம் இவரை இயற்கை தாத்தா அப்படின்னு சொல்லுவோம். சமீபத்தில் தான் இவர் காலமானார், 2013 இப்போ தான் காலமானார். ஓகே, ஹி எக்ஸ்பயர். ஹீ மேட் அ வெரி vast awareness among people regarding organic farming, okay, and natural farming. Okay, he is Dr. Norman E. Borlaug, an American agronomist. He is called as the father of the green revolution, and he has received and the Nobel Peace Prize in 1970. He is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. He joined with the Dr. Borlaug and in bringing the Green Revolution by introducing a Mexican wheat varieties. Okay. So, father of Green Revolution is Dr. Norman E. Borlaug. Okay, so he got a Nobel Prize in 1970. This Indian doctor M.S. Swaminathan joined with Dr. Borlaug and the Green Revolution was introduced. So there was a increased wheat production and also the rice production between 1960 to 2000. Semi-dwarf varieties in wheat and rice. Sonalika, Kalyan Sona are semi-draft varieties of wheat developed from high-yielding semi-dwarf fertilizer-responsive wheat varieties from Mexico. Okay, and this IR8 is a high-yielding semi-draft dwarf rice variety developed by International Rice Research Institute, IRRI, Philippines. In 1966, this was introduced in Philippines and also in India. Hybrid breed. What do you mean by hybrid breed? The offspring of two plants or animals of different species or varieties is called hybrid. Okay. For example, this IR8 rice is a hybrid of these two. What are they? High yield rice variety Pita from Indonesia, DGWG, a dwarf variety from China. These two are breed, okay, to produce this IR8. So Pita and DGO Woon Gen are breed to get IR8. What is plant breeding? Already I had told you plant breeding. So this plant breeding is necessarily required for disease resistance, for insect or pest resistance, for improved nutritional quality. Number one is disease resistant. See, there are many microorganisms or pathogens like viruses, bacteria, fungi. They cause plant disease. This affects the crop yield. Hence, it is important to develop disease resistant varieties of crop, right? That would increase the yield and reduce the use of fungicides and bactericides. So some disease resistant varieties are crop wheat, shimigri, resistant to diseases, leaf and stipe rust, and hill bunt. For cauliflower, pusa shrubra, pusa snowball, K1, it's black rot disease, it's resistance to black rot disease. Cowpea, it's a variety of cowpea, pusa komal, is a bacterial blight disease resistant. Okay, you can see the image here. This is Himgri. This is Pusa Snowball K1. And here is the Pusa Shabra. And this is the Pusa Komal. It's a pea type, beans type. Okay. So, insects are pest resistant varieties. The crop name is Brassica. Variety is Pusa Gaurav, resistant to insect pest like aphids. Aphids na vetikli mari rapuchi. Flat bean, Pusa Sem2, Pusa Sem3. It's resistant to insects or pest like leaf hopper, aphids and fruit borer. Next crop is lady's finger. The variety is Pusa Savani and Pusa A4. It is resistant to shoot and fruit borer. So this is Pusa Gaurav. This is Pusa Sem2. You can see here aphids, a grasshopper like insect. Okay. Here Pusa Savani, lady's finger. Improved nutritional quality. A major health problem will be there if there is a malnutrition. Okay, so among the population of India, there are many malnutrition people and undernutrition people. So it may cause a major health problem. We have to focus throughout the world on the human and farm animals. So the nutritional quality should be improved with respect to the protein content and quality of protein, oil content and mineral content. Okay, what are the protein content increase pananu, oil content improve pananu, mineral content improve pananu or crop la. Okay, so that human and farm animals, other living things around us, அதுக்கு என்ன கிடைக்கும், நல்ல நியூட்ரிஷனல் குவாலிட்டியான ஃபுட் கிடைக்கும். ஓகே. பயோ ஃபோர்டிஃபிகேஷன். வாட் இஸ் ஃபோர்டிஃபிகேஷன்? ஃபோர்டிஃபிகேஷன்னா வலுவூட்டுறது, சத்து கொடுக்கறது, நியூட்ரிஷியஸ் ஆக்கிறது. ஓகே, நியூட்ரிஷியஸ் ஃபுட்டாக ஆக்கிறது. ஓகே. So, biofortification is the scientific process of developing crop plants enriched with high levels of nutrients like vitamins, proteins, and minerals. You can see here the crop varieties developed by biofortification. Lysine rich maize breeds, maize hybrids. The protein are Shakti and Ratna. So these are the hybrid names. Okay, lysine is the protein. Okay, maize hybrids are Proteina, Shakti and Ratna. So these are developed in India. Iron rich fortified rice variety also developed using biofortification. And vitamin A rich vegetables are biofortified. Example, carrot, pumpkin and spinach. So these are biofortified foods available in India. Methods of plant breeding for crop improvement. So to improve the crop for plant breeding, there are some methods. First method is introduction of new variety of plants. Second one is we have to select which type of plant we have to improve. So we have to select accordingly for the improvement of crop. Next is polyploidy breeding and mutation breeding and then hybridization. Let us see one by one now. First is introduction of various new varieties of plants. Exotic species. Exotic species means it's a process of introducing high yielding varieties of plants from one place to another. Such plants are called exotic species. Okay, these imported plant material may contain or pathogens and pests. Okay, so hence it has to be tested and quarantined before being introduced into the fields. Example is Phaseolus mungo was introduced from China. This was quarantined before introducing to the fields. Selection. There are three methods of selection. One is mass selection. Two is pure line selection. Three is clonal selection. Mass selection. Actually, selection is the oldest method for the improvement of crop. First, in mass selection, seeds of best plants that shows desired characters or collected from a mixed population. Okay, from the mixed population, seeds has to be collected. The collected seeds are allowed to raise some generations. Till 7th or 8th generation, it should be allowed to raise. Then, this process of is carried out till up to 8th generation. Okay. So at the end, they will be multiplied and distributed to the farmers for cultivation. Example, groundnut varieties like TMV2 and AK10. So these are mass selected and multiplied and distributed to the farmers for cultivation. So this is the groundnut named TMV2. This is the schematic representation of mass selection. You can see here the mixed population. It means what now? You can see different types or different shapes of blocks like thing here. And out of this, only the red portions are selected. It means what? The good one. Okay. So that good one, good seeds are allowed to raise. So in the second generation, the good seeds raised, and we can see again a few good seeds, matured nutritional seeds. Okay. And those seeds are again repeated to allow to raise. Okay. So and the next generation passes, and the next generation passes similarly till 7th or 8th generation, we have to raise it. Okay. So at the end, we will be having a good nourished seeds. Okay. Next is pure line selection. Pure line selection is the progeny of a single individual obtained by self-breeding. It is an individual plant selection. Okay, so it is also called as individual plant selection. So in pure line selection, a large number of plants are selected from the self-pollinated crop and it is harvested individually. Okay, so individual plant progenies from them are evaluated separately. So each plant is evaluated separately. Out of that, the best one is released as the pure line variety. This progeny is similar to genotypically and phenotypically both have to be a similar one. Okay, so progeny is similar both phenotypical and in genotypical. Okay, next is clonal selection. Before clonal selection, let us just have a brief note on this selection method. So first year, you can see here old variety, a mixture of pure lines. Around 200 to 3000 plants are selected on the basis of their superior and similar phenotype. In the second year, you can see an individual plant progenies. So individual plant progenies are grown separately. Undesirable progenies are rejected here. Okay. So in the third year, preliminary yield trial is carried out. Here, remaining progenies are planned for preliminary yield trial. So here, remaining progenies are planted for preliminary yield trial. And fourth to seventh year, the multi-location yield trial is carried out. Means what? Low yield or inferior progenies are rejected. Replicated yield trials conducted at several locations. Inferior progenies are rejected. And disease resistant resistance and quality tests are done. Then in the eighth year, seed is multiplied. Best progeny is released as a new variety. Seed multiplication and distribution are performed. Okay, it is distributed to the farmer. So this is how the selection process carried out. Next is the clonal selection. What is clonal selection? Clone na ore madri achchasala ore mari innum irukkaradha clone nu solrom. Okay, so what is clone? A group of plants produced from a single plant through vegetative or asexual reproduction are called clones here. Okay, so asexual reproduction mulayama prepare avaradha the clones. Okay, what is clonal selection? Selection of desirable clones from the mixed population of vegetatively propagated crop is called clonal selection. Okay, so ore mixed population la ulla plants desirable clones pannam eduthittu adha vandu crop pannamna, that is called clonal selection. Okay, next method is polyploidy breeding. What is polyploidy breeding? Poly na many na. Okay, first poly means many. Polyploidy breeding means many, more than two sets. Okay, let us start with diploid. Diploid means two n. Okay, di inale two. Okay, two complete set of chromosomes in the somatic cells is called diploid. Diploid means 2n. Okay, haploid means n. If the gametic cells have only one set of chromosome, it is called haploid, n number appdin solluvom. Okay, polyploid means an organism having more than two sets of chromosomes is called polyploid, otherwise called as polyploidy. Okay, It is induced by physical agents such as heat or cold treatment, x-rays, and chemical agents like colchicine. Okay, so chemical agents like colchicine. Next is the achievement of polyploidy breeding. So there are some achievements: seedless watermelons 3N and bananas 3N. We might have had this seedless watermelons and bananas, right? Okay, 3N. 3N in potruk parunga, it means what? More than two sets of chromosomes are there. So it was developed by polyploidy breeding. Okay, TV29 triploid variety of tea with larger shoots and drought tolerance. Tea வந்து மலை பிரதேசங்கள்ல தான் அதிகமாக விளையும். அங்கே drought வந்துச்சுன்னா we have it should tolerate இந்த shoots வந்து tolerate பண்ணணும். அது தாங்கலன்னு drought தாங்கலைன்னா விழுந்துடும், வீணாகிடும் செடி. ஸோ அதை tolerate பண்ணுற அளவுக்கு இந்த breeding பண்ணியிருக்காங்க, plant breed பண்ணியிருக்காங்க. ஓகே, ஸோ வித் லார்ஜர் ஷூட்ஸ். ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட்டு ட்ரைட்டிகில். இட் இஸ் 6N. is a hybrid of wheat and rye. To make this plant fertile, polyploidy is induced. So it has higher dietary fiber and protein. Okay, Raphanobrassica is an allotetraploid by colchicine treatment. So these are the achievements of polyploidy breeding. Next is mutation breeding. Mutation breeding is defined as the sudden heritable change in the nucleotide sequence of DNA in an organism. What does it mean? Heritable change. அப்படினா என்னன்னா அதோடைய DNA கண்டென்ட்ல உள்ள நியூக்ளியோடைடு கொஞ்சம் சேஞ்ச் ஆயிருக்கும். Nowadays we are having this corona, no? This corona virus is also mutating itself. ஒரு ஒரு ரீப்ரொடக்ஷன் அப்பயும் இந்த கொரோனா செல் வந்து தன்னை மியூட்டேட் பண்ணிக்கிறதுனால தான் we are finding difficult to get the vaccine or the medicine for that, to cure that. Okay, and almost we got it seems. Let us see. Okay, now coming to the point, a process by which genetic variations are created, which in turn brings about changes in the organism. So this is called mutation breeding. Okay, genetic variation irukum, heritable change irukum. Okay, the organism which undergoes mutation is called mutant. Okay, the factors which induce mutations are known as mutagens or mutagenic agents. So induce pandra factors appear mutagens. Okay, so mutagens are two types. One is physical mutagens and another one is chemical mutagen. What are physical mutagens? Appdin pathina radiations like x-rays, alpha, beta and gamma rays, UV rays and temperature, etc., which induce mutations are called physical mutagens. Okay, in the radiation na appadina like oru neenga movies la paathirukalam, Hollywood movies la like alpha gamma rays edha pass aagum oru human ku la odane vandu avangalukku extra power kadachira maari irukum. So idellame vandu mutate aagradha, like oru chinna rat irukum adu mela this edha oru race indha maari pass aayirukum. அண்ட் அது பெரிய சைஸாக இருக்கலாம், ஆர் சின்ன சைஸாக இருக்கலாம், ஆர் மியூட்டேட் வேறு ஏதாவது மியூட்டேட் ஆகிருக்கலாம். ஸோ இந்த மாதிரிலாம் ஆறு தான் வந்துட்டு மியூட்டேஷன்னு சொல்கிறது. ஓகே, ஐ திங்க் ஃபென்டாஸ்டிக் ஃபோர்னு நினைக்கிறேன் அந்த மூவி பேர், இங்கிலீஷ் மூவி. அதில் கூட இப்படி தான் ஆகும். ஓகே, ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் கெமிக்கல் மியூட்டேஜன்ஸ். கெமிக்கல் சப்ஸ்டன்சஸ் தட் இன்டியூஸ் மியூட்டேஷன்ஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் கெமிக்கல் மியூட்டேஜன்ஸ். ஓகே, எக்ஸாம்பிள் மஸ்டர்ட் கேஸ் அண்ட் நைட்ரஸ் ஆசிட். The utilization of induced mutation in crop improvement is called mutation breeding. Okay, the use பண்ணி இந்த mutagens use பண்ணி crop improve பண்ணிருந்தா அது பேர் தான் வந்துட்டு mutation breeding. Okay, clear. Next is achievements of mutation breeding. Sharbati Sonora wheat produced from Sonora 64 by using gamma rays. So gamma rays use பண்ணி தான் இந்த Sharbati Sonora wheat produce பண்ணிருக்காங்க. From which one? Which species? Sonora 64. Okay. Next, atometer to rice with saline tolerance and pest resistance. So saline tolerance na soil la romba salinity adhigama irundhalume adu tolerate panni valarra alavukku idu kandupidichirukanga mutate panni breed pannirukanga. Okay. And also pest resistance. Next, groundnuts with thick shells. This also cultivated by mutation breeding. Okay. Next is hybridization. I had already told you what is hybrid is. Okay. Now, what is hybridization? It may be defined as the process of crossing two or more types of plants for bringing their desired characters together into one progeny called hybrid. Okay. Any desired characters. Okay. நம்மளுக்கு பிடிச்ச characters கூட எடுத்துக்கலாம். இந்த மாதிரி இந்த இந்த ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஒரு ஹைபிஸ்கஸ் ஃப்ளவர் இருக்குன்னு வைங்க அது ரெட் கலர் இருக்கும் பட் வி நீட் இட் ஆஸ் அ ஒயிட் கலர் பட் அந்த ஒயிட்ல வந்துட்டு சம் ரெட் ஆர் சம் அதர் கலர் அதில் ஸ்பாட்டடாக இருக்கணும் அப்படின்னா கூட வி மே ஹாவ் அ ஹைப்ரிட் ஷூ ஃப்ளவர் ஓகே தோஸ் ஆர் கால் டிசைட் கேரக்டர்ஸ் இல்லை எனக்கு ஷார்ட்டாக வேணும் இல்லை பெட்டல்ஸ் வந்துட்டு அதில் இருக்க பெட்டல்ஸ் வந்துட்டு நிறைய வேணும் எனக்கு ஆர் ஸ்மாலர் பெட்டல்ஸ் வேணும் அந்த மாதிரிலாம் நம்ம ஹைப்ரிட் பண்ணிக்கலாம் So hybridization may defined as the process of crossing two or more types of plants for bringing their desired characters together into one progeny is called hybrid. Okay. Hybrid is superior in one or more characters to both parents. Okay. So hybridization is the common method of creating genetic variations to get improved varieties. Okay. For improvisation of the varieties. I mean the crop only we are hybrid in the process pandrom okay idu experiment pathina triticale the first man made cereal hybrid okay it is obtained by crossing wheat species rendu irukku triticum durum innone cereal cereal appdinte idu rendume vandu enna pannanga cross panna we get a cereal hybrid okay so the F1 hybrid is sterile then the chromosome number is doubled using calcikine and it becomes a hexaploid triticale okay the cross பண்ணதனால 2n ன ஆயிடுச்சு 2n வந்து chemical mutagens வச்சு பண்ணிருக்காங்க calcikine okay Two main aspects of hybridization are to combine the characters of two plants in one plant and to utilize hybrid vigor. Okay. ஒரு தென்னமரம் இருக்கனா கூட ஷார்ட்டா dwarf தென்னமரம் அதுல தரையிலே வந்துட்டு இளநீ காய்க்கும் தேங்காய் காய்க்கும் ஓகே ஸோ இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு டூ பிளான்ஸ் அதோடைய கேரக்டர்ஸ் எடுத்துட்டு ஒரே பிளான்ட்டா மாத்துறது ஓகே லார்ஜ் கோகோனட் இன் ஷார்ட் ஆர் dwarf Dwarf coconut tree. It's an example. Okay. So two main aspects of hybridization are to combine the characters of two plants in one plant and to utilize hybrid vigor. Okay. So that's of now. I will attach the classwork in the next part of the video. Combine together. Okay. So revise it. Okay. Thank you.